gentlemen, boys and girls. My name is Joy Gaki and I'll be the narrator for the skit God With Us. Please enjoy. We are about to enjoy a story that has been told and retold for 2,000 years. The Nativity reveals something very special about God, that He was prepared to be with us and live among us. For a young boy called Kamau in Nakuru, the story has a real significance to his daily life. He says, "On Christmas Day, I remember that Jesus was born into poverty in a wooden house like mine. My family is poor, but this Christmas story gives me hope." Kamau, aged 12, lives in poverty in a dusty, dangerous shanty town on the outskirts of Nakuru. When his father abandoned his family, his mom Maribel struggled to cope and provide for Kamau. Angry and alone, Kamau spent more and more time hanging around on the streets. With no support, Maribel feared that she will lose Kamau forever. But Kamau's local church refused to let that happen. They called on a tear fund partner, Agape, to help. Now Kamau has realized he needs to be with his family and strive for a better future. Kamau did not end up as a street child, and his family is happy and together. They now have a strong faith in Jesus and are all active members of their local church. An outpouring of the local church, Agape, is God with Kamau and other struggling children in Nakuru. So let's see the story of how Jesus came to be with us, an event that is still transforming lives to this day. Imagine the stars in the skies, the countless constellations, the sprawling solar system, and among it, a little planet called Earth. God made all of those things and all of the people and inhabitants of our planet. Just over 2,000 years ago, when we most needed Him, God came down to be with us, to save us, and to show us how life should be lived. He could have chosen anywhere to be His home. He could have built a palace for Himself that would have made the grandeur of the Roman Empire seem like nothing. But He didn't. God chose to send His Son to be born among the forgotten, the overlooked, and the poorest. This is the story of how God came to be with us. The story opens with a young woman in her home, Mary. Unless you look a bit deeper, there's nothing particularly remarkable about Mary. She was from a town called Nazareth, and she was engaged to be married to Joseph. But to God, she was very important. So important that God sent an angel down from heaven with a message for her.
"Hello to you. You are very special. God is with you."
But Mary found it hard to understand why the angel had come to see her. She was just an ordinary woman. She worried what the angel meant by the greeting. Seeing she was scared, the angel said,
"Don't be afraid, Mary. God is very pleased with you. You will have a son. You will call him Jesus. He will be called the Son of the Most High."
"I don't understand. I'm not yet married. I'm a virgin. How can I have a son?"
"The Holy Spirit will come, and His power will give you a baby. He will be called the Son of God."
"I'm a servant of God. I believe it will happen as God, as you have said."
The angel departed, leaving Mary excited about the news of the baby. She told Joseph, the man she was about to marry, all about it. Caesar Augustus, who ruled over the land, sent an order saying he wanted to count every single person in the country. So everyone, including Mary and Joseph, had to go back to their hometown to be registered. So Joseph came from a faraway town called Bethlehem. Because Mary was engaged to be his wife, she came with him to Bethlehem. To save her aching leg, Mary rode on a donkey. During the journey, Mary was very nearly ready to give birth to her baby. Although tired and weary, Mary and Joseph traveled for many miles. They went from Nazareth in Galilee to Judea and then to Bethlehem. When they arrived in Bethlehem, they knocked on every door in the town looking for a place to stay. But everywhere was full of people. Each time they were given the same answer. Lots of people had come down to be counted, so the whole town was full. There were so many families to accommodate. Mary and Joseph nearly gave up, but then they tried the very last to get down. Please, please, help. My wife is about to have a baby. Do you have a room?
I'm so sorry. All my rooms are full with guests from across the country. All I can offer is my stable at the back. Where we keep all the animals?
Thank you so much. We'll take it.
Thank you. At last you have somewhere to stay.
So Mary and Joseph went to stay in the stable. It was very difficult. It was a very difficult place to bring new life into the world. Dirty, smelly, and unhygienic. But Mary and Joseph made the best of it. When the baby came, they wrapped little Jesus in the clothes they had. They didn't have anything to put him in, so they placed the Son of God in a manger, a trap that was used to feed animals. I'm not sure this is what Mary was expecting. The angel said that Jesus will be called the Son of the Most High. But as she looked at the sleeping baby in the manger, she knew that he was a precious gift. Meanwhile, in some fields nearby, a group of shepherds were keeping watch over their flock. It was nighttime, and they were surprised, to say the least, to see an angel of the Lord appear in front of them. The glory of God shone all around the shepherds. They were terrified. You see, these shepherds were just ordinary people going about their daily lives. They weren't considered very important. Nobody took much notice of them. So they were surprised when the angel spoke to them.
Do not be afraid. I bring you news of great joy. Today in Bethlehem, a Savior has been born. You will find him lying in a manger.
If this wasn't enough for the humble shepherds to take in, the angel was soon joined by a huge group of angels called the heavenly hosts. They said,
Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth.
The angels left and went up to heaven. The shepherds wondered what they should do next.
What should we do? Let's go to Bethlehem.
Yes, then you can see what has happened. I want to see what the Lord has told us.
they hurried off to seek Mary and Joseph and the baby, which they knew they would find lying in a manger. They found the stable where the young couple were, and the shepherds went in to see the baby in the manger. When they had seen him, the shepherds told everyone they met about the child. The people were amazed to hear the story. Are you amazed too? The Son of the Most High, born in a stable, someone who would be called the Son of God, placed in a dirty manger, with only poor shepherds to greet him. The angels said it was good news for the people across the world. And there is something about this birth that is good news, particularly for the poorest people on earth. Because when they see their Savior has come to dwell with them, not distance, but humbling himself, it offers hope to everyone in the world that they are accepted and can come to him, whether rich or poor, important or forgotten. Mary, who had seen it all happen, kept these things close to her heart. The shepherds went back to their flocks, but something had changed for them. They still had work and family. Nothing in their lives appeared to have changed except them. They glorified and praised God for the things they had heard and seen. They wanted to express the joy they had found and change the world around them. And what better way to celebrate the birth of Jesus? These humble shepherds had their lives transformed through an encounter with Jesus. So please welcome him into your hearts through this Christmas.
Joy to the world. Joy to the world. Oh, joy to the world.
Music Academy, where words fail, music speaks.